Hi guys, and welcome back to my channel. And if you're new here, my name is Hannah Renee, and it is so nice to meet you. Today we're going to be doing a Jesus talking video. I know that you clicked on this video and it said finding your purpose, but up here it says say yes to God. I think I'm going to change the name of this to finding your purpose. I just like that title better, but we're just going to be talking about callings and how to know what God is calling you to do or what you're supposed to be doing with your life. This could apply to Christians and non-Christians alike. So that's what we're going to be talking about. And without further ado, let's just jump right on into this video. Personally, I felt called to lead worship when I was 12 years old, and it was at a kids' camp, and I really just felt like that's what God wanted me to do. So everything that I've done since being 12 has been to prepare me for that, whether it's been music lessons or taking up opportunities anywhere that I could, or trainings and YouTube videos and anything that really had worship on it. I was there, I was watching it, I was doing all the things to prepare me for this calling that I really felt strongly was on my life. However, as I got older, I really felt the Lord shifting my calling, where I felt I was called to youth in general, not just leading worship like I was, but leading youth ministry, doing youth ministry, and having worship be a part of that. And that's currently what I do right now. And that's really been my journey with my calling. And I still don't know if that's what I'm going to be doing for the rest of my life. The Lord can call me to so many different things. I even think the Lord will use my YouTube channel as a part of my calling as well. There's no limits to what God can do with me. So that's been my journey, and I want to help you with your journey. I know it's confusing to figure out what you want to do for the rest of your life, but I want to clear some confusion, want to help you figure it out to the best of my ability. I talk to teenagers all the time. I talk to college students all the time, and the main thing that I hear from them is that they don't know what they're supposed to be doing. They don't know what they're called to do, and it's really stressful, especially high school seniors that are trying to figure out what to do after they graduate. It's a really stressful time to figure out, but I think there's really two simple things that we all are supposed to be doing and that we all are called to do. So let's get our Bibles out. The first one's in Mark. It's 12, 30 through 31. Chapter 12, verse 30 through 31. It says, love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, and with all your mind, and with all your strength. The second is this, love your neighbor as yourself. There is no commandment greater than these. And that's really simple. We were meant to love God, and we were meant to love other people. Simple, not super hard for all of us to do. The second one is in Matthew. It's Matthew 28, 19 through 20. Therefore, go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, and teaching them to obey everything I have commanded you, and surely I am with you always to the very end of the age. So what that is telling us is that we're called to make disciples. So now that we love Jesus and we love others, we're called to share the good news with others so that they can love Jesus too. So if that's our two main callings, then that's our basis that we can go off of. However, for everyone, that looks different. For me, I do that with youth ministry. I do that with talking to you guys on YouTube. But for somebody else, that could be working at a grocery store, or it could be being a nurse or being a police officer. There's really no limit to what you can do with those two callings. Another thing that I believe about callings is that we are not called to one thing for our entire lives. Yes, we're called to love people, all those things that I was talking about earlier. That's something we do for our entire lives, but I don't think that some people are called to be a nurse their entire life. I believe that God is a creative God, and He has flexibility, and He wants to put us in places and use us in situations that are different. And it just depends on the season that we're in. For some seasons, I've been a worship leader at my school. And for some seasons, I've been a worship leader at my church. And for some seasons, I've been both. For some seasons, I've been working at the church. For some seasons, I haven't. For some seasons, I've been playing sports. And for some seasons, I haven't. It's just every situation that I've been in has just been for a season, and I don't believe that's what I'm gonna do forever. Same with YouTube. This has been an awesome season for me. I believe it's gonna continue, and I really believe the Lord's gonna bless it. I don't think I'll do it forever, but I think this is a great season for me to be in now. So with all of this information that I've been telling you, there's a few things that you can do now with this. What you can do is you can ask God how he's calling you to love people, to love him, and to make disciples in the area that you're currently in. Even if it's just working at McDonald's, you can still do those three things at McDonald's. You can do it at your high school, you can do it in your college, your home, with your kids, with your families, whatever situation you're in, you can do those three things. So ask God how you're supposed to be doing that. Or another thing that you can ask God is maybe you're not supposed to continue in the season that you've been. Maybe he's calling you to quit your job at McDonald's and move on, or something like that. Maybe he's calling you to go to a different school or to be in a different friend group or something like that. He can use us in every situation, and we don't know how he's gonna use us until we get there. The thing is, you just have to be willing and you have to say yes, because God has opportunities for us in every situation that we're placed in, and we have no idea what it's like. It's gonna blow our minds. The people that we meet, the things he's gonna do through us, the lessons that we learn, just all of these things will blow our minds when we say yes to God. So for me, I've got to say yes to God in every opportunity. Like I said, I was preparing myself to lead worship with everything that I was doing, and with that, he allowed me to start leading worship at my youth group. He allowed me to lead worship at both of my high schools that I went to and my college. He gave me a job at the church. Now I'm a youth pastor. Just all of these things have just been a result because I've been faithful with the seasons that he's put me in so that he can take me to bigger seasons. So I hope that encourages you. I really want to see you all succeed and see you prosper and thrive and slay. I want to see you guys just live your best lives in what God has called you to do. And when we're faithful to what God is asking us, he's going to be faithful to us. And when we say yes, he's going to say yes to us. So what that means is when we're faithful to what he's asked us to do, he'll grant us the desires of our heart. And I'm talking about pure desires here. Things like maybe you want to have your own business someday. He'll give you that desire when you're faithful with the things he's asking you to do. So that's my encouragement for you today. Let me know if you have any questions in the comment section below, because I'd love to talk about this more. If there's anything that's on your mind on this subject, totally leave a comment, please. I'd love to chat. And that's the end of this video. Give this video a thumbs up, subscribe to this channel, and let me know of any other Jesus talking videos you'd like to see from me, because I'd love to do those for you. And that's it. I will see you guys next Wednesday. Bye, guys.